And that is when Torres unleashed the reality of abortion. And I caution you, you're going to need a strong stomach to listen to this tweet. Do you hear their screams? Torres was asked. No, she responded. You know fetuses can't scream, right? I transect the cord first, so there's no real opportunity if they're even far enough along to have a larynx. This woman is an abortionist. She says she cuts the throats of the babies she aborts so they don't scream. Joining me now, host of the Michael Knowles Show for the Daily Wire, Michael Knowles. Michael, thanks for joining me.
Liz, thank you for having me.
Michael, comment on this. Is this the choice that Democrats claim to champion?
As with so many evil things in this world, we can thank Hillary Clinton for this. The Clinton line on abortion for so long was that it should be safe, legal, and rare. But of course, this doesn't make any sense. If abortion is morally similar to murder, then it shouldn't be legal. And if abortion is not morally similar to murder, if it's just some regular procedure, then there's no reason that it should be rare. The Democrats have always tried to have it both ways here. Democrats like Mario Cuomo, Joe Biden, this guy who just won in Pennsylvania, Connor Lamb, they have this line. They say, I am personally opposed to abortion. I would never abort my child, but I support the political right to it, which is just another way of saying my precious progeny should have good lives. But all of those pesky people who take welfare and look different than I do, we should kill all of them so that there's more room for my children. It's an untenable position, and Democrats' sacramental view of abortion has now taken center stage, so they have to be defensive. They have to play defense here. Because not only are the philosophical questions in, not only are the philosophical answers in that their position doesn't make sense, but the science is in as well. Emerging and advancing sonogram technology allows us to see these babies. We now know, we can now see with our own two eyes that abortion stops a beating heart. These babies have beating hearts, usually before the women know that they're pregnant. We can now even 3D print images of our own future babies. These fetuses that they say, oh, it's just a clump of cells. We can now print it and see this is a baby. It puts them into a necessarily defensive position. And so many of their lies have been exposed. The pro-abortion movement, they said, before Roe v. Wade, 5,000 women a year were killed by illegal abortions. We know that isn't true. The real number was 39. 39 women were killed from illegal abortions the year before Roe v. Wade. Women were statistically more likely to be killed from legal abortions that year, from illegal ones. The lies are being exposed, and that's why pro-life is on the rise.